Hello everybody, Randy O'Neill here, and today's lesson is inspired by one of my followers, Joanna. Joanna, thank you for your questions, and instead of trying to just type an answer to you, you inspired me to create a video. So today's video, how do you move a OneNote notebook from one computer to another computer? There's a couple of ways that we could go about doing this. Number one, we could use the cloud service, just share our notebooks in the cloud, and then obviously they'd be accessible from any computer. But in this case, we're going to look at the hard copy version. How do we actually take the hard copy version of our notebook from computer A and put that hard copy onto computer B? So, Joanna, thank you for your question. Real quickly, as you guys see here in the very next question, but I cannot hear. Hopefully that has been corrected. I am now speaking on a brand new microphone. It is a great big microphone. I look like Walter Cronkite sitting here. But hopefully it's solving the problems. I love it. I love the way it sounds. So let's jump into answering this question for Joanna. And we're going to start by opening our OneNote notebook. Now, I don't care which notebook you open. If you have multiple notebooks at this point, I've got one here called the Textor. So this is the one that I'm going to use. What we're going to want to do for starters is we need to find out where our computer is storing our notebooks. And we're going to do that by clicking on our File tab. And then we're going to come down to Options. Now at this point, I'm assuming everybody's using 2013. If you're not using 2013, real quickly, you would click on a tab up here called Tools and then go into Options, and that would get you to the window we're headed to. And now we want to click on Save and Backup. Now right here in this top box, you see this is my default backup folder. On my C drive, under Users, under Randy O'Neill, App Data, blah, blah, blah. This is the file path that you're going to need to use to actually save this notebook on a flash drive. So now I know the default location. I'm going to close this, close everything. I'm going to come to my File Explorer tab. Go ahead and maximize that so you guys can see it. Now I'm going to come over here to my C drive. I'm going to double click it and locate my Users folder, which is right here. Double click that, and I want to get into Randy O'Neill. Now, once you're in this folder, I promise you, you're going to have to do a little bit of searching to find out exactly where your notebook is. Let me try Documents, and lo and behold, right there in Documents is my OneNote notebooks. So I'm going to double click this folder. I'm going to locate the notebook that I want to move. And you could possibly go ahead and just relocate this entire notebook. But in this case, I'm just going to double-click that. Couple of options to get these notebooks. Actually, let's go back. I'm going to move everything. Quick and easy way to move it. I can see everything on this side. Right there is my flash drive. So I know that within my flash drive, I have that. So I'm going to go back to my C drive. I'm going to come back to Users, back to Randy O'Neill, and get back on the same page you guys are on. And I am literally just going to grab my OneNote notebooks with a left click, and I'm going to drag it over here to my flash drive, and I'm going to drop it off. And what this is doing is this is taking all of my OneNote notebooks, sending them over there already in a folder called OneNote notebooks. The alternative would be to move individual notebooks one at a time. If your flash drive is as busy as mine, as I'm about to show you, then it can get very, 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 very confusing. So when I come back over here, I see that right there, I'm in my flash drive now, is my OneNote notebooks, and there's all of my notebooks. So now these notebooks have been saved to my flash drive. I'm going to go ahead and close this out, and I'm going to go ahead and eject my flash drive because that's a safe thing to do. Now at this point, I'm going to pause I'm going to switch computers. I'm going to go to another computer, which will be running a Windows 10 operating system. So don't let that confuse you guys. I've got a technical preview version on another machine. So the interface getting into my files may look a little different than what you're used to. Between these videos, I'm going to just include a snapshot of my new microphone. I told you I look like Walter Cronkite sitting here. You're going to believe it when you see the picture. So let me stop this video and we'll pick up on the next one. All right, everybody. Randy O'Neill back at you here. If I might add, with an empty cup of coffee, which really breaks my heart. But this is part two of the how to move OneNote notebooks from computer A to computer B. So we are physically moving the notebook from one computer to the next without using the cloud service. If you happen to have clicked on this video, if it shows up as a separate video, I would strongly encourage you to go to lesson one of these two, which if you're on the playlist would be lesson seven. This will be lesson eight. So picking up where we left off, what I've done at this point is I've simply just removed my flash drive from the laptop and it's now plugged into my desktop, and we are going to try and get these OneNote notebooks into my desktop. This again, I think I told you in the last video, is Windows 10. I do have a video, which I'll include a link in this video to the Windows 10 preview video. Windows 10's still not yet to be released until sometime in the summer of 2015. This is March the 26th of 2015, so we're still a few months away from the actual release. So what I want to do, remembering in the last video that I had to go into my user settings and all, I want to go ahead, maximize the screen so you can see it, and I want to locate my flash drive, which is here. I'm going to double click my flash drive and open it. But then over here on the left hand column under this PC, I want to keep my documents somewhere where I can click easily see them. Alright, right here, OneNote notebooks. As you can see, 53.8 megs, so it's a pretty good size folder. I'm just going to click and drag this folder over here to my documents, and it's froze up. I think I told you in the last video. No, maybe I didn't. This is a technical preview version of Windows 10, so there's some bugs they still have to fix, and right now we're dealing with one of those bugs. We're dealing with some lag. Things are just kind of froze. So we're going to wait them out. While we're doing that, I'd like to tell you guys a joke. Oh, no, I'm just kidding. My humor's not really good. Just trying to fill some dead space here. All right, let's see. I don't know if it went in there or not. It did. Okay, so it dropped. We couldn't see it. On your computer, you're probably not running a technical preview version, so you're probably good to go. I'm going to go ahead and double-click this folder, and I'm not seeing anything. Let's try this again. Let's go back to my OneNote notebooks, click and drag into my documents, and drop it. There we go. So apparently what happened first time around is by default I had my OneNote notebooks here, but it was an empty folder. Now, as you can see, all of my notebooks are moved in here. So let's go ahead and close this. And I am going to go ahead and eject my flash drive, just so you guys know I'm not pulling this from my flash drive. All right. And now I'm going to open OneNote 2013. You'll go about it a different way because obviously you're not using Windows 10. I got to go about it this way, OneNote 2013 right there. And as it's opening, I will keep my mouth moving just so there's no dead space. And let's see if it finds them. Let's open from my computer, from my documents, my OneNote notebooks, and let's see. Let's go to the Home Bills notebook. Open the notebook. All right. Let's see here. It would appear at this point that I've opened the wrong notebook, so let me back up, File, Open, and let's open from my computer, OneNote Notebooks, and Home Bills 2. Okay, there's the one we've been working on. Open the notebook. All right, there we go. And there's our active notebook. This is the one that we created in previous lessons. Created all these section tabs. Created pages under the power bill. All right, so that's it, guys. That is how you can transfer a OneNote notebook from computer A to computer B without actually backing it up in the cloud and opening it from the cloud service. So quick review. We must locate the location of our notebook first, which we do by coming over here under our File tab, File, and Options, and Save and Backup. Find our default folder on computer A. Go back, open that location by going through our C drive, which is where it told us it was at, and going through users, and so on and so forth. Save it. Just click and drag it over to your flash drive. Drop it. Eject your flash drive safely. Plug it into your new computer and go through the steps that we just did. So, again, Joanna, who asked this question, if I remember correctly, it was Joanna Schwartz. Thank you for asking this question and inspiring a new lesson for the OneNote tutorial. It's been a little while since I created one. I've been on delay because of the complaints that I was getting with sound quality. I wanted to try and get everything correct. So after this video, I hope I've answered your question, Joanna. I will value the feedback that you give me on this and everybody else. I hope this is helpful to you in some way, shape, or form. And I would also value the feedback from everybody on how the sound quality of the new videos are. Once again, thank you for watching my videos. Please, if you're not a follower, try to remember to subscribe. I do the best I can to take care of all of my followers and be the best that I can be at helping you guys achieve your goals. Have a great day.